Allah has two right hand. He doesn't have. He doesn't have left hand. He doesn't have. Here come another.
I am against
Islamophobe.
Islam is not a race. Mr. Muslim, please cry. You are young. And I think this is a good opportunity for you to get familiar with the Shin of Allah. Because if you don't recognize the Shin of Allah on the Day of Judgment, it's going to look very bad for you.
Are they tough guys?
Your Muhammad had a search with Maria and he spoke lie. He spoke lie with wife. With his wife, he spoke lie. With his wife, he spoke lie. So your Muhammad is the biggest liar. Your Muhammad is the biggest liar ever. Your Muhammad is the biggest liar ever.
You are liar.
So all these terrorists, they are hiding behind the mask. They are proving themselves that they are terrorists. Look at this. Here is a terrorist. Here is a Muslim from Palestine. Here is a Muslim from Palestine who is a terrorist. And all those who support Hamas, they are terrorists. All those who support Hamas, they are terrorists. They are terrorists, like.
We know.
Yeah.
Come on, we know.
Yeah.
Let's just move on now.
Excellent.
Come on, let's move on.
Excellent.
Don't discuss Excellent. With people wearing masks. That's embarrassing. Because we don't know who they are.
You need to go to mental hospital.
Oh.
Go to mental hospital.
Because his prophet was bewitched. Your prophet was bewitched. He need to go to hospital. Your prophet need to go to hospital.
Hallelujah.
Because he bewitched. Allah is a pagan god. And I can prove that. I can prove that from Quran and Hadith that Allah is a pagan god. Allah is the one who is giving Muhammad a satanic verse. Shaitan. Muhammad said, no, Shaitan has become a Muslim.
You are liar.
Shaitan has become a Muslim. So I can see many shaitan here.
Hallelujah.
According to Muhammad, these are our shaitan here. Look at these shaitan here. And let me show you Allah here. Let me show you your Allah. I have your Allah with me here.
Palestine is the problem.
By Allah.
I have your Allah is with me.
Allah is the same.
I have your Allah with me.
There is only one God.
Oh, my God does not have two right hands. My God does not have two right hands. Allah have two right hands and he does not have left hand. Two right hands. Look at this. 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 Allah has two right hands. He does not have left hand.
They're only here because you're engaging them. They're only here because they found amusement in you.
Excellent.
They found you amusing.
Excellent. At least they are learning.
No, they're not.
At least they are learning.
They think you're
from hadith.
They're not here.
They are learning from hadith here that Allah has two right hands. Can any Muslim tell me why Allah does not have left hand? What's the problem with that? Why Allah has no left hand?
The meaning of the hadith, they're trying to find the meaning of the hadith, but two right hands. When you say someone has a right hand, it means they're generous.
No. Why he had no left hand?
I'll explain to you.
Yeah.
When you say someone gives from the right hand, it means they're generous. It means
they'll get bored eventually.
Give two right hands, that means it's doubly generous. It's a metaphor.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So your Muhammad is saying this is a metaphor? Your Muhammad is not telling me this is a metaphor. Your Muhammad is not telling me this is metaphor. He is simply saying that Allah is having a two right hand. Two right hand. He does not have a left hand. What's the reason? What's the reason why Allah does not have a left hand?
Hadith is not Quran.
When he's talking about right
hadith
hand.
Is not Quran.
Oh, hadith is the Quran.
No, it's not.
Hadith is the word of Allah.
Hadith is not Quran.
Hadith are the word of Allah. Look, Allah's messenger.
Hadith.
Allah's messenger is saying.
Hadith being quoted.
Allah's messenger is saying
Bible
that Allah has two right hands, no
copied.
Left hand.
From Bible.
What's the reason?
Torah.
What's the reason?
Hadith.
Give me the reason.
Copied.
Give me the reason why Allah don't have.
He said it's a metaphor. Metaphor. He said metaphor.
That doesn't say. It's not written here.
The scholars.
It's not written here that this is a metaphor.
Where's that from?
Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari is telling me that Allah has two right hands.
Hadith are not Quran.
Oh, hadith are not Quran?
Hadith being copied.
They are coming from Allah.
Hadith from
they are coming from Allah.
No.
And Allah's messenger is receiving.
Quran came
Muhammad
from Allah.
Is receiving.
Quran
Muhammad is
Allah.
Receiving these verses.
Hadith
Muhammad is receiving
hadith
these hadiths.
Bible. Hadith
Muhammad is receiving
Torah.
These.
Hadith came from Bible.
No Christian have written this.
Hadith came from Torah.
No Christian have written this. This
Bible
is a Muslim.
Bible
this is
lie.
A Muslim who is writing this.
Bible
Sahih Bukhari
corrupted.
And Sahih Muslim, they are not Christian. They are Muslim. And they are well-known scholar. And it's not metaphor. It's not metaphor. No. That's not metaphor. You are just making up. You are just making up. You are just making up to cover your hadith here.
You're lawyer,
so you need
lawyer.
So you need a better God.
Lawyer,
you need a better God.
Lawyer,
here is a lie.
Lawyer,
here is a lie.
Lawyer,
here is a lie. Approved with proof.
Lawyer,
here is a lie with proof.
Lawyer,
here is a proof.
Lawyer,
here is a proof. Here is a proof. Here is a proof. Here is a proof. About Allah. Here is a proof. Here is a proof about Allah. Here is a proof about Allah. Yeah, I'm good.
Hallelujah! I am Son of God. I am Son.
The rights of police officers.
Allah Akbar.
And the people.
Allah Akbar. Allah Akbar.
So, Messiah. Whoever. Whoever. Whoever has claimed. Whoever has claimed to be Messiah. He died in the toilet. He died in the toilet.
Allah Akbar. Allah Akbar.
If you want to know the Messiah who died in the toilet?
That was you,
Ask those who claim that their leader is Messiah. Ask those
police officers.
They are members
of the those.
They are not Muslims.
They are not Muslims.
No.
Oh. They are not Muslims.
They are like you.
Okay.
They
are not Muslims.
They
are not Muslims. So, Ahmadiyya, they are not Muslims. Oh, they are
liar like you, liar.
So, Mirza Ghulam Ahmad.
Go to the mental hospital.
So, my sister. Mirza Ghulam Ahmad is not a Muslim. Is not a Muslim according to him. And Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, he claimed to be Messiah. He claimed to be Messiah. So ask the Mazai how he died. He died in the toilet. He died in the toilet with diarrhea. With diarrhea he died. He died with the diarrhea in the toilet.
Fine when she does it. Because she's abusing
and the right. Now you are saying they are not Muslim.
They are liars, like you liars.
Oh, they are liars.
They are liars.
So you are the biggest liar. And even your prophet. Even your prophet is the biggest liar.
Time to go to mental hospital.
Even your prophet is the biggest liar.
Go to mental hospital.
Let me tell you.
Go to mental hospital.
Let me tell you.
Medicine.
Look here. This is coming from Allah. This hadith is coming from Allah. And Allah's messenger is saying, Allah has two right hands. He doesn't have left hand. Here come another. Follower of two hand Allah.
All our lives here at this.
Here come another.
That's Hatim.
Two hand Allah follower. Two hand Allah. Follower.
The YouTube heads.
So, who is Allah?
Anyone under the bus.
Who is Allah?
Get those YouTube
heads. Who is Allah? The one who has two right hands. He does not have left hand.
I would beat Hatim to her dream.
So,
what an ass.
So, my friend, come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Jesus is the only way, the truth, and the life. You need that Jesus. You need Jesus.
People, because a human being has a relationship with a God. Hatim believes that's justified for her to attack you.
Liar!
Does Hatim abuse you for believing in a God?
Liar!
You're the wrong God.
She believed that. She believed the right God and Messiah. Right Messiah. She believed the right Messiah and right God, and that God can come on earth anytime he wants, any way he wants. That God she believed. That God she believed.
Beautiful. As long as you don't believe in a
God. Go away.
And then, if you do believe in a God, she'll be there to abuse you.
How does she abuse people?
And she'll abuse your God. And she comes here to abuse your God.
How?
Not appreciate you for having spirituality.
Huh?
She won't come here and appreciate
what do you mean by spirituality? Do you have spirituality?
Or a relationship
do you
with
have
God?
Spirituality?
She comes here to
do
attack
you have spirituality?
And with a
hope do you have spirituality?
That she can become a man.
If you don't have
on YouTube,
how can you tell other?
Glorify yourself.
How can you tell other?
But what the YouTube forgets to say is how she's just abused people randomly for believing in God. That's what YouTube forgets to say.
Yes.
And forgets to point out. And she will
at
not
least.
Stop.
Why do they call him dust? He looks like dust.
Until she finds somebody crazy enough. And then she can have that perfect relationship.
Yeah.
She does have a right relationship with God. Yeah.
Hey,
you need that God.
If you're having that.
You need that God.
Why
you need that God.
A Quran with holes
you
in
need
it.
That God who died
Quran
for you.
Filled with holes.
You need that God who died
so
for you.
She can abuse
you
people.
Need that God.
That's her Quran.
And so she can, but there is no Bible here filled with holes, is there, ladies and gentlemen?
Huh?
And that's because nobody needs to descend that low.
Thank you.
As a human being.
No.
Muslim's done that. No Muslim has drilled holes into a Bible.
No, they just blaspheme the Lord Jesus Christ every week.
Because it's justified.
It is, Dad. You know, they're
afraid. As you believe in a God.
Let me just address something for everyone. See the freedom of speech and speakers corner. People can come and then proclaim hate against me. It's absolutely fine. And Mr. and Mrs. police officers simply stand and then come alongside
of
them. It's absolutely fine. Speaker's corner becomes Sharia corner. It is absolutely fine in front of Mr. and Mrs. police officers. It's absolutely fine. But here's the problem. When Speaker's corner becomes official Sharia corner, I am afraid to tell you, which is going to break your heart.
Why?
Mr. Policeman, yeah. Mrs. Policewoman, those people who reject Allah and His Prophet, you will be the first on the line by the followers of Muhammad to take your head off.
Choppy.
I don't want to be mean, but that's what happens. You turn blind eye when Speaker's gonna take the first steps for Sharia corner. You turn simply blind eye. But when Speaker's corner becomes official Sharia corner, goodbye to freedom of speech.
Goodbye.
Not only goodbye to freedom of speech, but goodbye to Mr. Non-Muslim policewoman and non-Muslim policeman.
Wow.
Goodbye to them. Why?
Why?
Because you are non-Muslim. You do not worship Allah. You do not worship Muhammad.
Okay, so we are what?
What is it happening to you? You are the worst of creatures. Do you think followers of Islam is going to allow you to practice your worst of creatures version?
No.
They will crush you. I don't want to say those things.
Okay, but?
But I warn you, because you are turning blind eye. You turn blind eye when three Mr. Muslim decides to take over Speaker's Corner, mocks speakers, walks towards speakers on their face. It's absolutely fine. They need to be behind the Mr. Policeman. Why? They need a protection. Protected people group need a protection from Mr. Policeman. Why? Because of their religion versus Christian preacher is mocked, harassed. It's absolutely fine.
Yes.
Okay.
It's important. Oh, Mr. Policeman, please help us.
So they mock Christ?
I haven't come to that one. No, they need help from Mr. Policeman to simply stand on their feet. What happens next? One day they won't have Mr. Policeman. Why? Because it all turned to Sharia corner. Look at the basic lives of Muhammad. What happened to the Jews and non-Muslims in Medina? I can't read from the Islamic tradition that they were having hot chocolate party with Muhammad.
Pijama party. Pijama party, baby.
They were not even practicing Las Vegas with Muhammad. That's not funny. It's not funny, sister. Seriously, not funny. What happened to them? They were killed because of their belief. Simply not identifying Muhammad as a prophet. So it happened in the time of Muhammad. Do you think they will turn blind eye and let you go when it comes here?
No way.
Why? Because they did not allow people to get away soon after the death of of Muhammad. Muhammad died 632. Muhammad died 632. What happened after that? People decided to leave Islam. Mr. Abu Bakr, Mr. Abu Bakr, who is the father-in-law of Muhammad, who without any shame gave his child for Muhammad to climb top of her.
How old?
She was only 6 years old when Muhammad thought it was all right to have sex with her when she was 9 years old. Abu Bakr, who gave her his child, killed those who left the ideology of Islam. Whole 2 years, that's all he did. Whole 2 years, that's all he did. They took the sword alongside of them and then decided to conquer the world. Not with the flowers, not with the nice words, but with the sword. Look at the life of non-Muslims in Spain. Look at the persecution of non-Muslims in Spain in the history. And you think when they come to Speaker's Corner, they will give you roses? No. They will take your head off. If they didn't take your head off, they will start from your kidney, from your blood, and from your head. Step by step. And it's not going to be simply merciful punishment. Suffering and suffering. That's what Islam brings to the world. Why? Because Islam denies the God, real God. Islam denies the living God. Islam doesn't offer peace to anyone. Islam doesn't offer peace between man and God. Islam doesn't offer peace within humanity itself. So, when they conquered Speaker's Corner, when with the help of Mr. Policeman, Speaker's Corner becomes Sharia Corner, you will be the first on the line, Mr. Policeman and Mrs. Policewoman. That's how it's gonna be. Because that's how Islamic tradition teaches us. Sadly, 21st century, age of internet, age of social media, and no one learned. That's very disturbing. That should shock your head off.
What's the solution, Khatum?
You don't need to go so far for the solution. Solution is Lord Jesus Christ.
Hey.
It's quite okay at Speaker's Corner when Christian preacher on the ladder is being mocked. That was an hour ago. It is very okay at Speaker's Corner when masked Muslim, Mr. Muslim man, simply walk on Christian man. It's absolutely fine. Why? Because their ideology simply mocks my God. Not only Christians and Jews, but the ideology itself mocks my God. What do you expect? Them to have happily live happily after with you? No. Ideology who mocks Lord Jesus Christ. Its followers mocks Lord Jesus Christ. What do you expect? It does not go much. Islam is so dangerous and false ideology denies the sonship of Lord Jesus Christ. While the Bible says God has a son and that son gave himself on the cross for us, Islam comes and lies about my God. Since 610, my God is being mocked by the ideology followers of Islam. Since 610, Lord Jesus Christ is being mocked. Did Christian land and chop people's head off because it's been happened?
Yeah, they did in the Bible.
No! Wake up, sir. You don't even know the basics. Turn up the Speaker's Corner. I'm sorry, Sharia Corner. Islam denies every work of Lord Jesus Christ. He is the essentials for you to remember. It is coming. It is coming if you do not support. If you do not stand against it. It is coming. An ideology is out there coming to take over. As an Islam is ideologist, ideology of invaders. Not coming alongside and living with it, but ideology that invades.
What is the solution? The world is very much broken. It is in its full darkness. Solution to this broken world is only and only by and through Lord Jesus Christ. Eternal Son of God steps into this broken world and gave himself for us. There is no any other way, there is no any other solution for people to have peace with God and peace with one another. If you want to get rid of Islam, which you should.
Why do you want to get rid of Islam?
I am against
Islamophobe.
Islam is not a race. Oh, Mr. Muslim, please cry.
No, Mrs. Christian.
Please cry.
Yeah, exactly.
Islam is a race?
Can you admit you're an Islamophobe?
Islam is very dangerous ideology, I am afraid of Islam.
Difference between you and Chowdhury.
Islam is very dangerous ideology, and I am afraid of it.
No,
Muslims should be afraid of Islam. An ideology tells you you divorce a child.
You want to get rid of Islam?
Ideology tells you have a sex with a child.
Do you want to get rid of Islam?
Ideology tells you people's color is important. Ideology tells you you are the worst of creatures because of your belief. It is dangerous ideology. I am afraid of it.
You're afraid of it? That's not what I'm asking you. I'm asking you, do you want to get rid of Islam?
Who do you think you are demanding, sir?
Would you like to get rid of Islam?
Let's get rid of Islam altogether. It is very dangerous ideology. I'll wear that as a badge if I am Islamophobia.
She's not afraid of Islam.
I am afraid of Islam.
No,
Lord Muslims, I am afraid of Islam. When Islam takes over, you need to protect your wife.
Of course.
You need to protect your child. You need to protect your all incomes. You need to protect your head, your hands, your feet. You need to protect all of you and all of your house.
Exactly.
I am afraid of Islam. That doesn't mean I am Islamophobia. So what? I am afraid of Islam. It is very dangerous ideology. So I shouldn't come?
No, I'm saying you have courage.
I don't have a courage. I am Christian. I am Christian. Those people need Lord Jesus Christ. People need Lord Jesus Christ. But Islam is dangerous ideology. If you are not afraid of Islam, start reading the Quran. If you are not afraid of Islam, start reading the biography of Muhammad. Which angle you look, it is all very dangerous. But there is a good news. There is a good news. Good news is, while we are sinner, eternal Son of living God gave himself for us. That is the good news. Because of the death of Lord Jesus Christ, with his blood, our hearts, our minds, our brains, all of us is being washed away. Yes, we are brainwashed people by the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. And that's a privilege label for us. As he gave himself on the cross, he offers us place in the bosom of the Father. When you repent and turn to him, he opens his arms and he wants to have you. That's the good news. That's the goodness of Lord Jesus Christ, the one who loves you enough to give himself for you. But what is happening is, as Speaker's Corner is becoming Sharia Corner, with the control of Mr. Policeman and Mrs. Police Officers, that doesn't look very good at all. Really doesn't look good at all. While you are breathing out, while you are breathing in, you need to see and understand the glorious God with his glorious gospel. There is seriously no any other way of life in this world and after this life. Turn to Lord Jesus Christ. Turn to Lord Jesus Christ. While you are breathing in, and breathing out. Repent, people. It is serious. It is serious. You've got to repent. Heart of God cries for you because you chased the run away from him. That's heartbreaking. It's not that heartbreaking Islam is taking over speaker's corner, but it is more painful and heartbreaking as you are running away from the one who has holes in his hand and who has holes in his feet. People, repent and turn to the Son of Living God.
And those with whom they're in charge. Muhammad said that he had both his hands right.
So you're saying right as in right and wrong?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. But the problem is, it says they'll be sitting at the right hand of him. So in the context, it's talking about right hand in terms of direction. So when it says the two right hands is right, it means the two right hands.
What's
the
right?
Well, you
so
tell me.
What is the problem? Allah,
Allah,
don't
has,
have left
Allah has two right hands. He does not have left hand.
Yeah, and you can't balance with the two right hands. You can't even stand well.
Yeah. And also, Allah has only one shin. He does not
and
have.
He uncovers his shin.
Huh?
And he uncovers his shin like this.
He uncover his shin on the day of.
I think he's using the Bible. How did you know? You took a selfie with him or what? How did you know?
I didn't take a selfie with him because he's camera shy. But according to the Islamic tradition, people want... Yeah. According to Islamic tradition, according to Islamic tradition, people will recognize him from his shin. When he uncovers, when he uncovers, people will recognize him from his shin.
And also, Allah is going to... Allah is going to cool down the fire of Jahannam with his foot going in the fire.
Yeah, he's cold. Yeah? He's got cold blood.
And,
I never heard that before. And, waffle inside.
Are you
and
are
he
you
will
Muslim?
Say,
huh?
Kati,
are
you Kati.
Are you me what?
Are you Sunni Muslim?
Huh?
Yeah, both are Sunni, Sunni and Shia.
It's not the same, but I'll show you the reference.
You are Shia?
Huh?
You are Shia?
He said it's all the same. He said it's all the same.
Just Muslim, there's no Shia.
Make sure you don't say that in over there in that corner.
Why?
You won't be able to get away with that. I know, it's so funny. It's just so funny.
My password is 0000. I'll throw a punch.
What the? Bro.
I'm just going to show you the shin of Allah.
Shin of Allah.
What source is that, bro?
No, I'll give it to you.
I'll open the Quran. What source is that?
I will open the Quran.
Jarrah.
Yeah, I will give you the Quran. No worries. I've got the Quran in my bag. Just give me a second. Give me a second. Let me take my time. I'm just taking my time. Let me continue to take my time.
Yes.
Move down and then continue to take my time.
Yeah.
Let's continue to take my time until I come to the slide where we will see about the shin of Allah.
Oh, it's waffling, huh?
No.
It's the way.
The truth. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the right.
We know he's the way, but not the way. The way.
Come to Jesus.
What's
the
Jesus, the way?
Don't follow a false prophet.
Whoa, taking very long, man.
I'm still taking my time. It is taking a bit ages. Surah 68, verse 42. Have you got Quran on your phone?
100%.
Yeah.
68, 42.
68, 42. You're reading this time. Well, no way I'm reading that.
You're reading
no English, man. Reading.
This guy has no religion. No
reading. Jesus is the way. 42.
Not the way.
68,
42, yes.
42.
Are you still reading the Quran?
Read it.
Why are you so shy to read the Quran?
No, because he's
a disabled. Because he's not a Muslim and he's not a Christian. Yeah?
On the day when it befalleth in earnest, what's and they are ordered to prostrate themselves but are not able.
Read it again.
On the day when the shin will be exposed and they will be called upon to prostrate themselves, they will not be able to.
So can you be kind enough and then tell us about the shin of Allah?
Shia.
So who is this shin?
Say it again.
On that day when the shin is bare.
Uncovered.
That guy is reading it. He just read it.
So they read it and now he's trying to understand. It takes time for young generation to understand this day.
What's your point?
So I want you to tell me about the shin of Allah.
He's not talking about
shin of Allah.
The shin is about people.
In the verse it says, on that day the shin shall be bare, shall be laid bare. Surah 68 verse 42. It's here in Arabic as well. On that day when the shin will be exposed and they will be called upon to prostrate to.
Yeah.
So, I am curious about this shin. Is that, do you have a different Quran in here?
No.
No?
Always.
Okay.
Always there are.
So, it might be a different Quran, you never know.
Which surah is it?
Surah 68, verse 42. He read it, sir, the verse he read it. All I am expecting you to just unpack that shin to me.
It doesn't say shin.
Boy, can we English
that? What does it say?
It says
This Mr. Quran says shin.
Yeah. Wait. It says on the day it befelleth.
This is not I wrote it.
This Quran says it's shin. Look at the translation. Yeah. And then Arabic is the same. So we want to know about the shin.
Yeah, but who's translating it?
Like, this is Muslim. And this
let
is
me see your translation.
Yusuf Ali.
Okay.
Yusuf Ali.
What is this it?
Translator. Yusuf
what is
Ali.
That it is it? What is that it?
Who's that?
You don't know?
It is amazing that
you
are young.
Muslim you are?
It is amazing that you are a young generation and you can't even tell me what you understood, what you just read. Don't you find that a bit strange? Like you can't even understand what you are reading.
It's just school, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
No, I don't know what you are saying.
KSA, my school? Shit. They don't teach us.
So they don't teach you how to think. No. Very sad. You are our young generation. You just break my heart. Bless your heart. Bless your heart.
Hey, listen. Where's the Christian kid?
Come on, sir, tell us about the shin of Allah. Why are you running away from the shin of Allah?
They will be hiding like Muhammad when he put Ali on his back.
Let me say something.
Muhammad put Ali on his bed and he ran away.
Let me say something. You are young and I think this is good opportunity for you to get familiar with the shin of Allah, because if you don't recognize the shin of Allah on the day of judgment, it's going to look very bad for you.
That's right.
Those who doesn't recognize are going to go to hell.
Yeah.
So this is the opportunity for you to try to understand and think through what is the shin of Allah look like.
What is shin?
You don't even know what is shin? You don't even know what is shin?
That's shin.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So Allah has a shin.
And he's going to uncover it.
You don't know what does shin look like. Whether it's a stone shin, whether it's a plastic shin, whether it's a rubber shin.
What is the difference between the shin of Allah and your shin? Your shin is pretty hairy. Does Allah have hair in his shin?
Yeah. I will shave it tomorrow.
It's okay. It's okay. I don't mind you shave it or not. All I am asking is, does Allah has hair in his shin? What is the shin of Allah? It's different from
it.
Okay, so Allah has a shin, we just don't know what it looks like.
How will you recognize Allah? This is what Quran is saying. That you need to recognize Allah by his shin.
Let me read the hadith for you. Sahih Bukhari 532. Okay? Do you know any sign by which you can recognize Allah? They will say the shin. and Allah will then uncover his shin. This is Mr. Allah, suddenly uncovers his shin and then people can recognize him from his shin.
If
so, what is the difference between your shin and Allah's shin?
Yeah. Allah's a human.
What?
Why
do
you speak Allah's a
human?
I don't know.
What is it? Huh? Why are you guys speaking like Allah's a human? We don't know.
But Allah is a shin, we are trying to
find
what
shin is. Quran is telling you. Quran is telling you that Allah is a human.
He's not a human.
Allah is a human. Allah is having a shin.
Allah has two right hands. Allah has two right hands. Allah has face. Allah has cold hands. Allah has shin. Allah has a throne. Someone is cutting those throats.
So are you saying Allah is putting his metaphor in the fire?
Yes.
To help
metaphor in the fire?
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
Talk to your daughter. She knows better than you.
So you are saying Allah is putting his metaphor.
His daughter
converted to Islam
because
she knows what's right.
So this is science fan young generation. How many times they simply lie about you?
Explain it to your daughter. Your daughter chose the right religion. Yeah. Explain it to her.
My daughter, they are wise enough. They are wise enough. And they cannot follow the false prophet. They cannot follow the false prophet. And they cannot follow the false religion. They cannot read the satanic book. So we are telling you to quit that Muhammad and quit that satanic book and come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Jesus is the only life.
Convey your daughter before you speak to us.
This is what I already told you.
Allah
has two right hands. Allah has two right hands. And
Jesus loves you.
They are living.
Jesus loves
they
you.
Jesus
loves you.
I love him more than you.
You are such a liar.
I love him more than you.
Why do you deny his death? Why do you deny his death? Why do you deny his death?
Yes.
I deny his death. He's alive.
Oh, he's alive.
He's alive.
He died and he conquered the grave.
You still believe Muhammad as that person and you still believe him.
So what? Are you going to kill my father now? Pull yourself together now. Let me put it very simple. I am not Muhammad. I'm not Muhammad.
Your Quran is the biggest rubbish ever. Satanic book. My daughter, they are wise enough. They will not follow the satanic book.
Let me just summarize what's happening.
Yes.
Okay. The moment Muslims needs to figure out what the shin of Allah look like, because that's the question brother was asking.
Yes.
Allah has two right hands. Yep. Two right hands. That means Allah is failing with the balancing. If you don't have the left arm, left hand, how you are gonna balance? It's gonna be difficult.
This Allah
puts his feet on her. This Allah has a shin. Young generation of protected group come across with the shin of Allah. All they do is run away from the shin of Allah. I find that's very not helpful at all. You know why? Because now as they run away from the shin of Allah on the day of resurrection, they have no clue how to figure out whose shin is this. If they don't recognize Allah from his shin, welcome to the barbecue in hell. Not very nice at all. Burned barbecue in hell. That was great opportunity for Muslims to figure out the shin of Allah, practice, and then get, when they see in the future, they will know. We saw shin of young man, hairy, dark shin, but we don't know if Allah shaved his shin. We don't know if Allah even like writes, has a tattoo on his shin. I don't know.
And
I don't know.
And maybe that shin is a
is it white
stone?
That's very racist now. That's very racist right now. But Allah is racist anyway. Today you can run away from the shin of Allah.
Yeah.
Goodness is, on the day of judgment, Allah won't be there. You will be standing in front of the Lamb of God. And you will be asking mountains and rocks to hide you from the wrath of the Lamb of God.
Yeah.
Because it is Lamb of God who is going to judge you.
That's right.
And Lamb of God is not going to say, oh, look at my glorious shin. He's not going to do that. Lamb of God is going to ask you, did you know him and what you've done about it? Today, you deny. On the day of resurrection, it's going to be very much too late.
He is coming as a justice judge.
Yeah?
Justice
judge. Not any judge, but a just judge who is going to judge all the living and all the dead ones.
Yeah. Thank you.